To the new set of wheels, my newspaper had the most curious ad in its listing of automobiles. I smiled with suspicious amusement at what seemed like a great stroke of luck. Corvette Stingray, it said. Low mileage, bright red. 94 vintage, $65. Well, I'm used to my newspaper's errors, so I picked up the phone straight away. About the Corvette, have you sold the car yet? She said, no, you're my first call today. I said, there's been a mistake in the paper. They printed the price wrong somehow. No, they haven't, said she. They got that straight from me. I said, don't sell the car, I'm leaving right now. Well, she lived in that part of the city where I'd ventured just one time or two, where doctors, bank presidents and lawyers were residents, and the houses were massive and huge. As I pulled up the half mile of driveway, there in the heat of the day, in the sunshine it gleamed, the car of my dreams, only $65 away. Well, the interior was done in white leather. The engine was a massive V8. The white cabrio top, like new from the shop. It had an 8-track, 8-deck, solid state, whatever that may be. There was chrome on the chrome, on the chromium. It had an aerodynamic design. There was a bar, a TV, and amazing to me, for just $65, it was mine. Well, I thought that this woman was crazy, selling the car at that price. But as we walked down the lane, she seemed perfectly sane. She was charming and really quite nice. She smiled with great satisfaction as she handed me papers and keys. I said, I've just got to know why you let this thing go. What's wrong with the car? Tell me, please. Well, she said, I'll be 60 on Tuesday, and I've lived here with my husband, Earl. And after 30 years wed, without a word said, he ran off with some silly young girl. But he left his credit cards here on the table, and I knew that he wouldn't get far. And last night from Florida, he texted to me, I need money, dear. Please, sell the car. Thank you very much. It's...